home too.
So, and I've been battling this cold, this sinus infection. And it just really, like, I went through all my body, and I missed a couple services. I missed, like, about 2.5 weeks, but it seems like it was about 3 months. Anyway, when you're out, it feels that way. You know, when you don't come to church, it feels like it's a long time. So, because I couldn't be in church, I felt so sick. I go to work, and I come home, and I go to bed. I go to work, and I come home, and go to bed. And I get up, and I do a little bit around the house, and Brother Jose says something to me, and he says, I don't feel good. I'm doing it, but I don't feel good. And I can feel my body, feel like it didn't want to go. My spirit wanted to go, but my body didn't want to go because I was very, very tired. I felt like I couldn't move no more. I couldn't go no more. And I pray at night time, I said, God, please help me, you know. I don't feel good. And I said, I want to go to church. I want to be in church because I miss when I'm not here, I miss it. I really miss it because I want to be here. And so that Sunday, I came to church in the morning in the Spanish service, and I felt like, I said, well, I want to go home, and I want to go back, and I want to go to bed because my body just did not want to go. I felt tired. I felt sick. I feel like I was battling something. I don't know what it was, but my body was doing something. I don't know what it was. So anyway, I came at 2 o'clock. I said, I got to come down at 2 o'clock, and I said, I go to play. And I started playing, and I could start feeling the Lord, you know, and I said, well, I go over there in the throne and get prayer. Well, I went for prayer, and I keep saying, God, I need your strength. And Brother Mano was praying for me, and I said, Lord, I need your strength. I can't make it no more. I told Brother Mano, I can't make it no more. I feel like I can't go no more. I don't have no strength in my body. But he keep praying for me, and I said, Lord, please help me. Give me strength. Give me strength. And I keep saying, I know I'm trusting you. But I was doing it with my sincere heart, not with my mouth, but with sincere heart. I said, I trust in you, Lord. I trust in you, Lord. Well, I was here in the afternoon, and I come back in at nighttime. So I went 3 services that Sunday. God gave me the strength to go through.
Yes.
He gave me the strength to go through. And then I told Gina, I think, and I say, on Monday, I got to call the doctor because I'm not feeling good. Well, when I get up Monday morning, I'm full of energy. I'm full like I was a young
glory to God.
Old girl. Man. I feel so good.
Man.
So
hallelujah.
I have not called the doctor. I did not call the doctor, but I know the doctor was the one upstairs.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he touched my body. Besides that, I was full of energy for Monday. Then I went to work.
Yes.
And I went out to Publix to put some plastic bag in the container, and I fell down.
Yeah.
I fell down. And when I fell down, I got up so fast that I didn't know if anybody was looking at me or no. I got so much energy, I got up, get in the car, and I went to work. See, we need to trust it. Sometimes we say that we trust in the Lord. Sometimes we say that. But we do that we really trust the Lord in our heart, with our heart, with the really, really sincerely, we just say, Lord, yes, I trust you, and I know you will do the work. I think that sometimes we just do it with the mouth, but not deep inside.
Yes.
And I appreciate the Lord for that, because that was last weekend, and I still go full tilt. I'm going still full tilt. And I said, thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And the thing is, Brother Jose, they upset with me. I go full tilt. I say, woman, sit down. Sit down. And I go. The other day I took my house and I started dirty. And I think finished almost 11 o'clock.
Yes.
I mean, that's the strength that I have. Yeah. And before that, a week ago, I couldn't move. So God gave me the strength. That's what we have to do. We have to believe in Jesus Christ that he can do the work.
Come on.
Yeah. And no matter what we go through, we need to trust in him that he will do it. Sooner or later, he will do it, God. And I really trust the Lord, and I believe in Jesus Christ. And I thank God that he has touched my body, because I've been going through a lot of sickness. I mean, I know my body. I've been in the hospital and everything else, but you know what? I put it in the hands of the Lord.
Amen.
I said, Lord, you do whatever you want to. And I do what I say. If it's time for me to go, Lord, let it be.
Amen.
If it's not time for me to go, I said, let it be. So that's the way I see it. I really don't worry about. I put everything in the hands of the Lord because I know that he will take care. One way like today, I went a little bit somewhere, and I said, "You said you go to say." I said, "No, I have to go. I have to get dressed. I have to take a shower, take a dress, and I have to be in church." I wanted to hear because God put me over here, and I'm trying to be here the much as I can. You know, I don't. You know, when I'm not here, believe me, when I'm not here, it's because I don't feel well. If I'm well, I'm right here. And even a lot of times that I don't feel well, I still be here. I come. Because I want to come to church because I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful for everything that he does for me and my family. I'm so grateful. And I can't bring him enough. I can't do it. So by me come to church, I'm playing the band, it satisfies me. It really does. And I really thank him that he has put that faithfulness inside me. I really thank him. That he has walked, and I pray, I said, "God, please help me to walk with you every day of my life. Help me to be an example. I work here and everywhere that I go. Help me to be an example." And I appreciate that. And I said, "Give me love, then I can give that love to the other person." Amen. And I do it my ladies. I do them at work, and they say, "Amanda, you are so nice." And I say, "No, I'm not. It's Jesus Christ inside me."
Amen.
And I tell them, and then you go to church,
you accept
the Lord. But I tell them, I said, "You know, you're trying to be nice and you're trying to be kind." And I give him a hug and I kiss him and I say, "I will see you next week. I'll bless you. I'll see you next week." She said, "You're so sweet. You're so kind." And I tell him, I said, "No me. You don't know me. That's Jesus in me. Because without having Jesus,
Amen.
Amen.
You have to have Jesus Christ inside you. For you to be humble, for you to love your brother, for you to help anybody, because God put that inside of you. God, he's the only one who does it. God put that inside you for you to be kind to your brother and sister and love them and help them the much as you can. And I, like I say, I appreciate the Lord tonight for what he has put inside my heart, for the love and the understanding. And come over here and listen to the word of God, because that will keep you. That will help you. The word of God, it will help you if you will understand what they're saying there. Because it's not just reading it and reading it and reading it, but read what it's saying there. When you say, "Love your brother and your sister, be a sacrifice," all those little things, you know, if you understand that, if you understand, God will help you.
Amen.
And you'll be more in church, and you'll be more lovable, more kind. Amen. I know that we have a spirit there that sometimes don't want to be kind and don't want to be lovable. But you can call on him, and I say, "God, please help me. Help me. Yes. Help me, Lord. Help me to be kind. Help me to talk to that person. Help me to testify to that person. Help me to give him a hope to that person that really means it. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord." Because that he's there to help you. To walk with you.
Yes.
And I go in my car every day to work. And I the people next to me and the other cars see me, they think I'm nuts. But I'm talking to Jesus. And things come in my mind. You know, things come in my mind about the Lord, and I try to be in contact with the Lord. And I try, when I go to work, I try to be nice and kind over there. You know, sometimes it's a little upsetting, but I go to the bathroom, I say, "Lord, you have to help me in this situation. You have to help me, Lord, because it's a little bit too strong now. It's a little bit too strong." And I go back there, and I go with a smile, and laughing, and carry on. You see, that's what we have to do. That's what we have to do.
Amen.
So anyway, I love you all.
Lord, of us,
Lord, for Jesus loves you more than I do.
Oh, Jesus.
He does. He really does. He really loves you more than I do.
Amen.
And I really appreciate the Lord. And continue serving God. And trusting him.
Him.
I believe in him,
okay,
that he will do the work. Sometimes he don't do it right away, but he do it later. He does. He does. Like Sister Judy said, she prayed for his family to come to church. She might not see it now, but maybe later on, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, we might see it. And his time.
Amen.
His time. God bless you. I love you. And